Yeah, good morning guys. Today we are getting into introduction to business analytics. We are going to look at what is business analytics and what is the difference relationship between analytics and business intelligence, and how the business analytics is useful in the process of decision making within the industry or within the business setup, and what are all the major three steps involved in business analytics, and data classification and measurement. How the data is classified into different category and how we need to look at. This is what your objective, but we need to understand what is the real need of business analytics. If you look at this, yesterday I have picked it from the social media. If you look at, they are clearly explaining 98 million job for software development, 23 million job for cloud and data roles. Look at the opportunity which is right in front of us. 20 million job for data analysis, machine learning and artificial intelligence. Put together, it's going to become around 50 million cloud and data roles, and standalone without cloud, you can perform analytics and you can do machine learning and deployment, whatever you look at all together. There are 50 million job opportunities, cybersecurity, privacy and trust. That is for data level security or application level security, platform level security, that all comes into security altogether. So this is the hot cake right in front of us. So how much we are grooming ourselves towards this makes a lot of difference in our future career selection. Not only this opportunity in the industry, also in the teaching domain as well. It's going to become rapidly increasing day by day. Machine learning expertise in order to facilitate teaching. Some of you may be interested to take into teaching and training domain. So by that time also, you have a great career, not only in the business perspective or working in the industry setup, as well as equally we have the opportunity to be a great facilitator or trainer or teacher role. So this is how the indication of why we need to be thorough on centric to the data. This is per minute internet data acquisition or data streaming in 2019. Imagine right now, if we can't even imagine, per minute 4.8 million Giphy, and if you look at basket, how much it is, Netflix, how much hours watched, Google, Facebook. Now, after lockdown, I can imagine that these all the data point would become double. I can 100% assure. Even Google mail and Google server are becoming down. Even if you start sending mail, it takes 5 minutes minimum to dispatch from one end to another end. Earlier, it would take maximum of 1 or 2 minutes. So this is the indication the availability of data says. Beyond that, across the globe, 7.7 billion global population. Out of that, why the data comes, why the data is revolving around us? Because of digitization, all the e-commerce business and transactions and availability of IoT, availability of robotics, everything into web application or web related transactions or online internet based business transactions, and industry 4.0 automation. Industry 4.0 is all about automation. The moment we are automating, every pinpoint we need to pursue. Recently, in the Srishailam, Andhra Pradesh, collapse happened in the power station. Big data with the power grid is the famous topic it's going on. So there are around 9 engineers died due to that. All the plants at a time have got fire accident. So I'm not sure whether they have automated or not. That part I'm not sure. So these are all the accidents can be avoided through this kind of data analysis or data streaming or automated way of looking into things, industrial setup, industry 4.0. So this is how. So the statistics says these many billions of people have unique mobile, then have internet account, have these many billions people are active in the social media, any one of the social media, WhatsApp, Instagram, anything you consider, LinkedIn, Twitter, Facebook, then accessing over a million these many members, 94% of them are accessing the information through their mobile phones. So that because of voluminous of data, we may need to personalize recommendation, personal assistant, language translation, security analysis, emotion analysis, so many, plenty. So not only the conventional data, there are data is considered into three types: structured data, unstructured data, semi-structured data. Depending upon the variety of the data, nature of the data, we need to stick to either machine learning or the deep learning. Deep learning is a subset of machine learning. Machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence, it's a kind of bigger picture. I can say it's exactly theoretical perspective I can say. When it comes practical, hands-on, the very immediate higher picture is machine learning algorithm. A subset of machine learning can be said as deep learning. So this the terminology perspective keep changing. But artificial intelligence is a big picture. Machine learning is a second level. Then subset of machine learning becomes deep learning. So we need to choose an algorithm or the model depending upon the data. So similarly, depending upon the business problem statement, business perspective, what kind of action we need to take decision. Depending upon these two, data and the problem statement or identification of the problem or identification of the crisis, identification of the challenges, what exactly all together formulates or leads to the selection of an algorithm. When it comes to the business analytics introduction, we may need to be thorough on few of the terminologies. Let us see what are all. Business analytics begins with the data set. Data is a key role player when it comes to analytics, also business analytics. In general, if we speak analytics, it can be applicable to any domain, irrespective of healthcare domain or any domain, weather prediction, anything. Exactly, business analytics stands for how we can make it our business to become profitable. So only in the e-commerce sector or business sector, this particular terminology would be useful. Simple collection of data and data file. Finally, data analytics is starting with acquisition of data or gathering the required data, either in terms of data or in terms of files, several files. So subsequently, database. It's a collection of data, files. So database, the moment we say, it is the collection of information we used to call about people, about location, date of birth, age, degree, whatever, all put together, collection of files can be termed as database. Then the next terminology would become data warehousing. It's a collection of several databases. It's a larger picture, that's all. Database is applicable only for the particular scenario. When it becomes data warehouse, several scenarios combined together to treat it as data warehousing. So that's it. Now, when it comes after the moment we say data warehouse, immediately the sibling of data warehouse is big data. What is big data? If we understand big data, it is a larger and complex collection of data and the software together. Larger collection of data, complex system of software together working in order to take business decisions, in order to automate, in order to derive intelligence or information out of it. Now, when it comes big data, normally people used to start with 3 V's, then 4 V, it had gone now 7 V's, maybe many more V's also. Now I would like to hear from you, or you can unmute yourself, you can communicate to me, or you can use the chat window for communication. Can you point out what are all those V's? You are all aware of this all. Anyway, in order to take a lead, I am, big data.
So, velocity, variety, and volume and veracity are some of the V's.
Exactly. Variety, volume, and veracity, these are all predominantly used. Now it had increased up to 7 V's. Let us see what are all those V's. Yeah, just to take a lead, I was asking you, fine. Volume, it will be in the form of terabyte, petabyte. It had gone to volume. Variety, It could be structured data, unstructured data, or semi-structured data. Or else in other way around, I can represent for your understanding. A conventional data in the form of numerical and categorical, or in the form of text representation, or it could be large text representation. When it comes social media analytics, full of text revolves around. We are communicating most of the time through text, then image, audio, video. These are all the types of data revolves around. Geomaps, after GPRS, geomaps, lot of mapping representations, all together are said to be variety. Velocity, how much, see, imagine that all social media, per minute, how much information is generated, veracity, that is what it stands for, velocity. How much speed, streaming of data. Veracity, insightful, whether all the data becomes insightful, meaningful for the business. Not at all. For example, you and me sitting and chit-chatting in the Facebook. Hi, how are you? Do you have class today? I'm not at all going to class. I feel bored. I don't have internet. These are all something you are talking. Will it become insightful for their business? That is a question mark. Rather, if you are talking about the political scenario of today's situation or precaution for COVID, something like that, if you are talking, then scientific applications, we are talking for upon some domain. Civil engineering domain, mechanical engineering, that would become insightful for them. So what exactly people are talking about, how much information they can understand from the people, and what is a culture, what is a trend about the present ruling party, how people are having opinion, whether they have positive opinion or negative opinion about the ruling party, or when the election comes closer, whether which party will win the election. That we will be start creating threads. We will be having some prediction, some curiosity. We will be setting the stage. These are all the merits of this party. This party may win. So that are all called insight for them. So not all the data will become insight. Whatever, even Netflix. Netflix is not into this kind of chit chat. But there are few points will become insightful. Every day, how the person is spending on Netflix. What are all the movie he or she is clicking? What language movie he or she watches most of the time? That all the pinpoint for recommendation. So all the data will not become meaningful. What exactly will become meaningful is called veracity. Identifying the meaningful data for the meaningful insight. So that is what veracity. Variability. Every time the data will give different combinations. Different inferences, different, the same column, but depending upon the data pattern availability will give different meaning. For example, Amazon sale, women fashion wear, all other date would be different. When it comes festival, it speaks different. So that variability will be there. Women fashion wear is fixed, that is a column. But how many pieces are moving, or which kind of fashion wear is moving fast, that varies from season to season. The women wear which we are preferring 2020 Diwali will become different from 2021 Diwali, because people will be looking at trendiness. That particular trendiness people will look at. That is what it's called variability. Visualization. Unless otherwise we visualize the data, or we do statistical analysis, anything, inferences. If we are not ready to take the inferences, we may not increase the value of the business. So that for rhythm, we are using visualization, but it could be another kind of analytics. It could be descriptive analytics, predictive analytics, prescriptive analytics. We will be looking shortly what are all these definitions one after one. So visualization. Finally, we need to add value to our business. Not just capturing the data, just keeping it dumped. We need to bring value out of the data. We need to increase the business profitability. Look at whenever Amazon, Flipkart, any online e-commerce business we look at, they will be giving 1 rupee offer. They will keep one particular product, salt 1 rupee, sugar 1 rupee, something like that they will keep. Why that 1 rupee? How? You may need to think. So they used to go for association rule mining. Which product goes with which combination? The trendiness. How the customer trend goes. Then they will look at the pair of the product. they will keep one of the product into cheaper rate, then they will compensate with another product. That is how the data helps them. So they will promote like that. Suppose any of the product is stagnant in their rack, in their basket or showroom, then they will be promoting that also through association rule mining. Which product if we give combination through this, so that before that expiry date, they can keep selling it. So lot of inferences, lot of insights are going on. I will be discussing about Uber case study shortly, how the data is helpful for Uber business, entire Uber or Ola, whatever, this kind of business, how it will become. Let us look into that later. So this is what value, how the data is helping to increase the value of the business. They need to profit, they need to make profit, it should become profitable. For that, what they need to look at? Either they can attract customer, one way they give discount. Why they are giving discount? First, we need to think about it. One way they need to attract customer. Another way, before that expiry date, those are all the products need to be sold out. For that, how need to be attracted the customer? Then they will look into expiry date, stock, inventory stock, how much is available, what is the deadline, everything they will analyze. Then they will find out the combo, which product is going more with which product. That market basket analysis they used to call. This is famous problem. So based on this market basket analysis, either they will apply any one of the combination, then they will give introductory offer or discount offer for both of the product, or they will waive price for one, they will increase price for another one, so that they will promote and they will be increasing the business value. So here, not only increasing the business value, that all the expiry date product need to be sold out 1 month, 2 months before. It could not be kept in the basket or in the stock inventory. So that all item need to be disposed. Every problem will become different. What is the problem we are facing? Whether we are trying to increase a profit, or we are facing the challenge or any kind of particular problem erupts, how we need to look at that particular scenario. Scenario is important. Next to the scenario, that is what we used to call technical people problem statement. Scenario is becoming problem statement. Relevant data we need to acquire. Then after understanding the scenario or problem statement and the data, only then we can move on towards the finding out the solution or the methodology or the algorithm. So very first primary thing, these three. In order to understand the data, in order to understand the problem scenario, domain intelligence is important. In and out of that business, everyone should understand what's happening. If it becomes agricultural domain, data will become different. If it is business data, it will be different. Although it is business data, every business belief system, every business value will become different. The pattern of business will be different. The way in which the commodity services will become different. So we need to understand exactly what's happening in that particular domain. Domain intelligence is much more prior or important than even data. Then data becomes very prior. Data is ready to speak with us. Are you ready to listen? That is what the question, proverb. So we need to understand the data, what exactly it's speaking, how the data differs, why this data comes. Then after this second understanding, only third level you need to go. What algorithm I need to choose? That becomes third. Then after jump into the algorithmic model, then all the jargon comes. Statistical, mathematical perspectives, linear algebra, differential calculus or differentiation, then statistics, probability. These are all the major mathematical model we should be aware of. Statistics, probability, linear algebra, differential calculus. Calculus, simply calculus. These are all the four mathematics essential. Not even to the deeper level. Very, very preliminary level, but deeper understanding is required. Then the moment we jump into the model, these four comes into the picture. In addition to these four, coding. We must be good at any one of the coding language. It could be Python, R, Julia, or MATLAB, or Java, or SAS, anything. Financial domain, most of the time people are using SAS. So we need to understand which domain vertical we are going with the data. For that suitable language, we may need to pick. Then fourth stage coming to the picture, programming is coming to the picture, fourth stage only. Then fifth stage, different models, different approaches in order to improve the accuracy, model validation parameters, all those things comes later. This is the sequence we need to move on when we come to the business intelligence. The moment we come into business intelligence, we should, these all interchangeable word, analytics, business analytics, business intelligence, all are interrelated, interchangeable words. When we get into business analytics, the primary purpose is not the model. We should not jump into the model. Our primary role is to understand or having domain intelligence. This is the primary role of any analyst should become. After the domain intelligence, next we need to understand scenario. After the scenario, we need to go for understand the scenario, business scenario. Rather, I can say business domain intelligence or business intelligence. You should have exactly what is all about your business. In and out of the clear picture, we should have. Then after the business scenario, problem statement. Exactly, we need to articulate what we are expecting. After this business after the problem statement, we need to look at understanding the data. Here, data is ready to speak with you. Are you ready to listen or learn? This is what the mantra. When we understand the data, next the picture comes into what is the model, which model or algorithm we need to choose. Once we understand the model, in order to understand the model, one should be good at statistics, probability. Then coming to the next scenario is linear algebra. Next is calculus. These are all the items we need to be thorough on. Once the person becomes good at these all, next, language, programming, coding is essential. Primarily, it is popular. Primarily, people are widely using across the globe Python for both machine learning and deep learning. If you wish, you can choose any other combination. Julia definitely is going to become lead after a couple of years because of the speed of processing, lightweight, the compiler itself lightweight. Subsequently, the speed of computation is much faster than Python. So that is expected, predicted to become popular. SAS, Java, Scala, whatever you feel so, you can use MATLAB. So these are all the language selection. Subsequently, you need to choose the language. Once this language is decided, we may need to move with the next step, model building. After model building only comes to the accuracy or model improvement. At time you may be good at improving the model, or else, or validation matrices. Validation matrices only, you will come to know whether this is good or bad. Then you will think of improvement, or choose the model improvement, then revalidate. And if works well, you are happy. If not, change the model. Choose another model or change the model. These are all the steps involved anyone. Then not only change the model, immediately we need to think of how we can increase the value of the business. Next, interpretation. results and interpretation. When it becomes business intelligence, it goes towards the business interpretation, results and interpretation. Then change action or a necessary action need to be taken to implement or incorporate into the business. This is how the sequence of steps goes with business intelligence. Whatever the perspective you look at, these are all highly important to think in this perspective. So all together I couldn't fit. Okay, let it be. So yeah, no other space. If you have any doubt, you can clarify then and there. So these are all the steps we may need to consider when it becomes business intelligence or any kind of analytics. Ultimately, we are doing for the revenue making or for usefulness for the society and for the public. So it naturally it becomes business intelligence. Anything we look at, see, even weather prediction, weather forecasting, this also has business intelligence. So how many umbrella I can sold out depending upon the weather? If it is extremely hot also, umbrella selling will become more. Or cool drinks, the preparation of food in my hotel business. Anything we can look at in any perspective. So that even though you are working on weather prediction, that increases the value of business indirectly. So it doesn't matter what data we are analyzing, every data analysis directly or indirectly connected with the business. So that is the ultimate message I can say. Coming to that, involves with analytics can be involved as a process, use statistical technique majorly. Then normally this is measure of central tendency, graphs and so on. Information system software, data mining, sorting routines. For most of the analysis, we will be using software, inbuilt, ready-made software. We have plenty of software like Vika, Orange, Talend, ETL tools. So many softwares available for depending upon the model which we want to do. If we look at Hadoop ecosystem or Spark ecosystem, there are plenty of availability of utilities for sorting techniques, larger number of data sorting techniques. So whenever we are using any of the system, information system software for our analytics, then it becomes data mining. Then the moment we go to prescriptive analytics, prescriptive analytics uses operation research methodology. Majorly, it is involved with linear programming or operation research methodology. This prescriptive analytics or any kind of analytics starts with exploring, visualization, discovering and communicate patterns or trends in the data. This communication only, I said, results and interpretation. Either oral communication, that is data storytelling we used to tell, or data journal. Either we can communicate orally, that is data storytelling. Then we can communicate with the written, that is data journal. So this kind of way we need to communicate with our business stakeholders. Who are all the business stakeholders? Shortly we will be discussing. So each and every business stakeholder we may need to take into action further depending upon the trend or prediction, they need to put that into an action. So that is what we are going to discuss. Look at now, analytics converts data into useful information. Ultimately we are doing this only. We need to convert it into useful information. Now, analytics is an older term to all the discipline. We all may be hearing in the past 5 years widely. Earlier it was there, entire one decade I can say. Data analytics, artificial intelligence, big data, these are all most popular, especially in the last 5 years. Past 1 or 1.5 decade it is popular. Even a common layman, other disciplines, other domain people also, not only computer science people, all are talking about machine learning and data science or analytics. Look at, this is older term I said. So how it is becoming older term? So look at, this is a data science timeline. 1943 itself, people, McCullough and Pitt, thought about neural net, which is required for deep learning. Then mathematics theory of communication established in Shannon, the very popular Shannon theory for information communication theory, 1948. Computing machinery and intelligence, Turing, 1950, he have proposed, Alan Turing have proposed. Look at what is a heritage of data science. That is why this word, older term. So if you look at timeline, recent 2019 onwards, most used programming language in the world for machine learning or data analytics or deep learning. So this, after this, it becomes famous. Why it becomes famous? Because of the availability of data, digitization of the business, entire opportunity or communication is taking place with digital medium. Especially after lockdown, education is also brought into the digital medium. Complete conversation. Virtual class or video material or placing the text material or any kind of LMS which is provided by teacher is sitting on the internet. So this all and all the communications and the correspondence, even video, audio call, video call, this all becomes data. So voluminous of data is becoming more and more day by day. That necessitates in order to become popular. This data analytics or data business intelligence, business analytics, why it is becoming popular, that reason I am putting forth, nothing more. Then coming to the variety of data, text data, image data, audio data, video data. What we can do with each and every data. So these are all the application when it comes. Look into this bigger perspective, not only the data analytics, you will be looking into structured data. Not unstructured data, you are all not stepping into neural network models, that is deep learning. You will be with only the conventional models. However, understanding this all would become helpful for further career setup. Okay, coming to here, Siri, Alexa, Google search audio note, Google audio, all those things. Applications of AI. Without that, it is not possible. Chatbots. Every business domain, the moment we open the website, immediately communication, conversation will happen. Who is doing? Not 24 hours people can sit at. So they will be deploying chatbot into their website. So it will be communicating with us. Chatbot everywhere, recent days available. Even IRCTC deploying chatbot. So these are all the way. Chatbot, the moment we use chatbots, artificial intelligence, natural language processing comes to the picture. Language translation, Google does language translation. There are plenty of softwares available for language translation, one language to another language. Emotion analysis. Why this emotion analysis they have brought? There should be a question for you. This emotion analysis, if you look at any of the supermarket or malls, if I ask you to fill up the survey form, do you feel happy with our mall, whatever we are doing the services, are you okay, that kind of thing, if you ask, 90% of the people will be refusing because they are going for relaxing themselves. By the time also if we approach them for what would be your view of so and so product, my mall or my shop, something like that, they may not showing interest. So that people are have everywhere nowadays monitoring, web camera is deployed across a supermarket or mall. So that will be watching for their safety and security they have installed. So they are converting the other purpose of it. So through that camera, they are kept on tracking the object detection, face recognition. From that, they are understanding the harmony of the people or emotion of the people. When they look at the product and when they see how they are seeing it, what is the emotion they are expressing, or which portion they are showing happiness, which portion they are showing denial. So much analysis people are doing without even communicating with the customer. They are understanding about every point with the customer. That is the business value or business intelligence goes with the AI and the data analytics. Predicting property price, dynamic price fixing. So that is what you will be dealing with the fourth unit. Dynamic price fixing. That is very, very popular and hot cake today because every time, even Amazon, Flipkart also, they will understand competitors' selling rate. Then they will understand the rate of the product and what is the margin of their profit. whether they can give to their competitor level equally, or they can go up or they can go down, whether that product is available with other competitors or not. So much analysis happening, dynamic price fixing. If you look at Ola and Uber, absolutely dynamic price fixing. Air ticket reservation, dynamic price fixing. So the moment you come to dynamic price fixing, the mathematical model would become different. Every scenario or every kind of analytics will keep changing with slightly a mathematical model. When it comes to dynamic price fixing, you may need to use a lot of stochastic models. So that is where our linear programming, operations research. So that is where you will be successful with the dynamic price fixing. So it's very hot cake of the day today. The next, video surveillance. Yeah, that is what for safety and security I said. Na? If it is a jewelry shop, very big jewelry showrooms. So video surveillance along with intelligence, it will say all the suspicious or misbehavior or unusual behaviors, it will predict. If it is public, if the surveillance camera is installed in the public street, then they will find out all the strike and unusual gathering of the people, unusual movement or unusual people approaching that area. That is a kind. Even every house nowadays, video surveillance camera is installed. Every apartment is installed. So that's all. But not only installing, what we are doing out of it is called intelligence. That is where now intelligence comes into the picture, all the models. Earlier, people used to install the camera that will be stored in the server. Anything goes wrong, they will look back to the video. Maybe once in a week they will be deleting, auto deletion they will keep. 1 week video or 10 days video they will retain the footages. Rest all they will delete. Then one, or depending upon their server capacity, maybe 1 month also they will retain the footage, then they will delete. Nowadays, not even required to delete. All the intelligent parts only stored in the server, all other usual analysis or usual pattern of video will be thrown away. That is where the beauty of artificial intelligence plays a role for this video surveillance. So object detection. Nowadays, object detection, so many applications. After this COVID, I used to see a lot of object detection method. Even in the railway station in the abroad, they are detecting all the faces. It is immediately, fraction of second, it counts. How many vehicles are there inside the train, bullet train, and how many people are standing in the platform. So it starts matching and giving the direction which compartment people are less. You go to that compartment. It gives a lot of digital displays for ease of customers or customer satisfaction. So that level people had gone. Object detection. Any method you can use. I'm saying one scenario, object detection. When it comes to Gmail autocomplete, whenever we are typing, the moment I use respected sir, I used to keep next word warm greetings in all my mail. Immediately it is recommending next line also. Now how I am drafting a mail in my earlier scenario, it starts learning out of that and it starts recommending. So warm greetings automatically it is telling. You would have noticed Gmail, then incomplete sentences also. Not only this example, whenever we are typing, it suggests a lot of filling words, incomplete sentences. These are all the use of applications of AI. Especially in your syllabus fourth unit, dynamic price fixing only you are looking into a lot. That is hot cake of the day. Understanding that would give you a bright future. There are many types of analytics. Broadly, it is categorized into descriptive, predictive, and prescriptive. So this is what the definition proposed by Institute of Operation Research and Management Sciences. So this is a website just based on your textbook I am quoting. But nowadays these words are revolving around everywhere. Not only this institution proposes, all the business proposes, Amazon, every business model, Google, Google provides a lot of online courses. If you read those all, everyone, a common layman also proposing three types of analytics. So when it comes to descriptive, predictive, and prescriptive analytics, what is descriptive analytics? It talks about the past, whatever the accumulated data, out of that, what we can understand about the past is given by descriptive. Normally people used to say, mean, mode, median, interquartile range, central tendencies, variance, covariance, range, standard deviation. These are all the methods used for descriptive analysis. Many more. We will be coefficient of variability. We will be looking into few when that particular moment comes. So whenever we use these kind of analysis, bar chart also descriptive analysis, histogram also descriptive analytics, cumulative probability distribution is also descriptive analytics. So what that data says, what is the existing data, historical data says what? Whenever we are looking into historical perspective, last 1 month analysis, last 6 months analysis of my business pattern, last 1 year analysis of my business pattern, past 5 years, what was the trend during Christmas and New Year season? What was the trend during Dasara season? That all becomes descriptive analysis. Predictive analysis, it advanced statistical information software, they are telling. We all know predictive analysis. One is prediction. Numerical prediction. There are two predictions again comes into picture. One is all about numerical prediction. What we want exactly, the numerical values we need to keep predicting. The moment we use numerical or continuous values or quantification. Quantification means precisely or approximately I need to quantify the numerical value. That when it becomes quantification, it is called linear regression. When it becomes classification, that is called logistic regression. Both are into prediction only. One is qualitative prediction, one is quantitative prediction to the crisp word. The moment you are working on quantitative prediction, when you are going for qualitative prediction, then it becomes logistic regression. So that's all. These are all the two models you would be discussing upon predictive modeling or predictive analytics in your forthcoming chapters. Then prescriptive analysis. Then it comes, the moment prescriptive analysis comes, the mathematical technique which you are using, linear programming, operations research, or stochastic model. Till prescriptive analytics, everywhere you will be using deterministic model. What is deterministic? Input, process, output. It will become clear. If I do build a model sitting at here, or if you sit at America or Australia, anywhere if you sit and build a model, it will become same for all of us. But when it becomes stochastic model, the parameter how it marks depending upon that, the model also changes. So that is what prescriptive analytics. When it, these are all the major three analytics you may need to understand. This is what your complete syllabus walks through. Descriptive analytics, predictive analytics, prescriptive analytics. Most of the time your syllabus is focused on prescriptive analytics. That is what I could notice. Rest all the theoretical discussion or how you can take it forward to the business value. So that is kind of articulation it is set. That's all. So these are all the explanation note for this. When it comes purpose, example. See, when it becomes purpose, trends in a larger data sets or database is to get rough picture of what generally the data looks like and what criteria might have potential for identifying trends or future business behavior. Based on the past, you can take inferences for the future business also. So that is the mere purpose of descriptive analytics. When it comes mean, mode, median, standard deviation, charts, graphs, sorting methods, frequency distribution, probability distribution, sampling methods, normal distribution or sampling methods, all these kind of understanding will help for that is the purpose of descriptive or example for descriptive analytics. When it becomes predictive, designated to identify and predict future trends, unseen data, it needs to find out the trend, that is called predictive. Here we will be using ANOVA, information system methods like data mining, operation research methods like forecasting, or as I mentioned, the regression, multiple regression or logistic regression. These are all for predictive analytics. That is why I'm keeping here, predictive analytics. When it comes prescriptive analytics, allocates resources optimally, resource allocation or dynamic price fixing, both are said to be prescriptive analytics, for which we may need to be thorough on research methodology, operation research methodology, linear programming and decision theory. The moment a decision theory plays a role, stochastic model. Stochastic model only can use decision theory. Next, characteristics. You can just go through these characteristics. I'll be sharing this in the Google Classroom. You can go through this. Analytics. What is the meaning of analytics? What is happening and what will be happening? Business analytics. What is happening now? What will be happening? And what is the best strategy to deal with it? To deal with the business scenario. Business intelligence. What is happening now? And what have we done in the past to deal with it? So what went right, what went wrong in the past, how we need to drive the business in the future, not only long future, every minute people are predicting, every day people are predicting, every month, every seasonality business trend also people are sitting and predicting. So that is where it differs. If you look at on the whole, the definition also will become same. Use of descriptive analytics as a major component of analysis. Yes, it is useful for all the three. Descriptive analytics becomes a vital even for predictive and prescriptive analytics. We need to understand, we need to walk through. That is the way where I said now that major steps in which data model, before that data pre-processing and data cleaning, 70%, at least 60 to 70% of the time every data scientist or analyst need to invest their time and effort on data cleaning and data pre-processing and exploratory data analysis. These are all the three combinations. So for that, descriptive data analytics becomes pivotal. Without that, we can't build any model. In order to build the model, it is required. That is why it is applicable for all the three. When it becomes analytics, these all are important. That is why they are emphasizing yes for all of these three. One minute. It is data pre-processing. It is important. Data cleaning. All are almost interchangeable word. Subtle difference. Exploratory analysis. 60 to 80% of the time it is required to invest on it. For these all, descriptive analytics highly useful. 60 to 80% of time and effort need to be channelized for these three. That is why it is said as important for all the three categories. Next, coming to use of predictive analytics, is a major component of analysis. Yes, yes. Business intelligence, no. Only historical is enough. It is all the perspective. I can say all the question, yes for all, everywhere. I can say no is not at all required. Focus of storing and maintaining data, analytics not required. Business analytics not required, but for intelligence it is required, they are saying. It is depending upon the perspective. Required focus of improving business value and performance, analytics not at all required. Business analytics, yes, required. Intelligence not at all required. So this all depending upon the business model. Even I can say this cannot become generic, but however it is dealt in your textbook, it cannot become generic and firm. So it's a depending upon the business domain, depending upon the scenario, business scenario only, these all can be argued. No need to worry. You just understand these three, nothing to learn from this table. Okay. When it becomes business analytics process, how it is taking place. So business database or data set or data warehouse, you either you can use it as data warehouse or you can use it as database. Then business computer cloud data storage, where this data warehouse is there, definitely they should have their own storage or they should have cloud storage. Then business reports, lot of reports that web application, web model or web software will be developing or generating. Then descriptive analytics, what happened in the past, that is a primary concern of descriptive analytics. Find possible business related opportunities based on the past history. Suppose in your e-commerce cloth showroom, women fashion wear is moving fast in the past 1 month. You need to fill with your cupboard with women fashion show than men fashion wear. So that is where people are attracted with your business. So that says what happened in the past and what will happen in the future. Next, predictive analytics. What's happening, why it is happening, and what will happen. All together, we can able to take decision with the predictive analytics. Opportunities in which the firm can take advantage. Prediction always will take advantage for the business value. How shall it handled? Prescriptive analytics, how to handle the situation. Allocating resource or dynamic price fixing. These all becomes prescriptive analytics. Then all the three together only outcome of the entire business. We can't bits and pieces, we can't say all the three at time. We may need to interrelate one at a time. We may need to look at, that is what I'm saying. It's merely depending upon the challenge which the business entrepreneur faces or the pitfalls or the crisis what the business entrepreneur faces. It's depending upon absolutely the business scenario. Then the data nature, these two only decides what model we need to choose. Within this descriptive analytics, again, it is a big or a bigger picture. It is again, ocean of collection, I can say. Predictive analytics, again, it is a larger picture. If you use optimization model along with this all, it will become different. If you use fuzzy model along with all the predictive analytics, it will become different. So within that predictive analytics, again, three category, supervised learning, unsupervised learning, and reinforcement learning. When it becomes prescriptive analytics, again, it is a ocean, complete stochastic model, operation research, linear programming, we may need to apply. So every analytics, again, it becomes a branches in it, depending upon the scenario, context, and the data nature. So the major picture only we are discussing, descriptive, predictive, prescriptive, within which again it goes into lot of category. Okay, with that I would be concluding, because if I touch upon next topic it would take much more time. Guys, if you